Following news that the IDF carried out 3 separate airstrikes back to back, which killed 7 humanitarian aid workers from various countries, Benjamin Netanyahu came out and made excuses for the deadly drone strikes. And unfortunately, the United States government has provided cover for Israel. So before we get to the US government and their reaction, I want to talk a little bit about the victims here. So the victims included 1 Australian woman who's a longtime humanitarian aid worker by the name of Lal Zami Frankcom. 3 British nationals, a Polish man by the name of Damian Sobel, and an American Canadian dual citizen, a Palestinian driver from Rafah, was also killed in the drone strikes. Now, in response to this, Benjamin Netanyahu, the Prime Minister of Israel, came out and took ownership, saying that this happens in wartime. Does it? Does it happen in wartime?
It does if you're the leader.
Do you target humanitarian aid convoy in war and just slaughter them? Okay, well, he also continues to say, we are thoroughly looking into it, are in contact with the governments, and will do everything to ensure it does not happen again.
Total lie.
That is a lie, because this has happened. This has happened multiple times. This time, it's really, really standing out, considering the fact that these are international humanitarian aid workers. And so Israel and the way it has carried out this war on Gaza has essentially alienated Israel and the international community. This kind of situation that we're talking about right now will further alienate Israel from the global community, which is why the Israelis who have taken to the streets to demand the ouster of Benjamin Netanyahu and his far right government are doing the right thing. He has been incredibly counterproductive to Israel and the people there. Now, let's talk about the reaction from John Kirby, who held a press conference today and was asked about the intentions of the IDF in carrying out these 3 drone strikes back to back, which killed everyone in that humanitarian aid convoy. Let's watch what he had to say.
Is firing a missile at people delivering food and killing not a violation of international humanitarian law?
Well, the Israelis have already admitted that this was a mistake that they made. They're doing an investigation. They'll get to the bottom of this. Let's not get ahead of that. Your question presumes at this very early hour that it was a deliberate strike, that they knew exactly what they were hitting, that they were hitting aid workers and did it on purpose. And there's no evidence of that. I would also remind you, sir, that we continue to look at incidents as they occur. The State Department has a process in place. And to date, as you and I are speaking, they have not found any incidents where the Israelis have violated international humanitarian law. And lest you think we don't take it seriously, I can assure you that we do. We look at this in real time.
They have never violated international humanitarian law ever in the past 5 to 6 months.
I'm telling you, the State Department has looked at incidents in the past and has yet to determine that any of those incidents violate international humanitarian law.
Well, our State Department lacks any and all credibility. The Israeli government has admitted, and this is based on reporting by an Israeli publication, Haaretz, that they knew the coordinates of the humanitarian aid convoy, and that they intentionally struck the humanitarian aid convoy because they suspected that the convoy may have had 1 armed terrorist. There's been no evidence of that. It was just based on a suspicion. And they had no problem carrying out 3 separate drone strikes back to back that slaughtered 7 innocent people as they were attempting to deliver food in Gaza. Cenk.
So let's be clear, John Kirby's obituary, hopefully many, many years from now, should start with John Kirby helped to commit a genocide, helped to murder tens of thousands of Palestinians, and covered up the war crimes on behalf of Benjamin Netanyahu. He's a genocide denier. He's a genocide aider and abettor. He's a terrible, immoral human being, as is his boss, Joe Biden. I don't ever, ever want to hear anyone telling me Joe Biden is such a sweet, empathetic man.
Agreed.
No, he's empathetic to people that are in the room. And who's in the room? APAC's in the room, Raytheon's in the room, ExxonMobil's in the room, every donor and lobbyist is in the room, and he has overwhelming empathy for them as long as they bring a check for his corrupt, disgusting, vile office, let's put it that way.
Yeah.
But if you're a Palestinian, he has nothing but contempt for you, and he finances your genocide. So right now, John Kirby with that outrageous, I mean, of all the things. Now, you know how Ronna McDaniel, everybody ran her out of town because, oh, I can't believe she supported the big lie of the 2020 election. True, okay, I agree with that. How about this big lie?
Well, this big lie is okay when liberal media provides cover for it. Let's keep it real, Cenk. Overall, in terms of mainstream media, there is absolutely a pro-Democrat bias where you can literally have John Kirby lie to the American people with a straight face about how there's no war crimes committed by Israel when we all know they are, that there are. We have seen them, we have covered them. The international community is in agreement about the war crimes that are being committed. But there's no John Kirby is a respectful human being, whereas, you know, the liars on the right wing, well, we shouldn't, you know, at all give them any fairness, any credit. It's look, this is the reason why there is distrust toward the media. This is the reason why, you know, Trump supporters will not trust anything coming out of the CNNs of the world, the cable news outlets of the world, and the New York Times, Washington Post, if they're not being fair. They're just not fair. They will provide cover for Kirby for sure.
So you are 100% right. And let me double down on that in a couple of ways. Number one, imagine now if that was Trump's spokesperson, Pentagon spokesperson, and it wasn't Israel, it was Russia. And Russia had just killed 32,000 people in Ukraine, 23,000 of them women and children. Russia said, yeah, we targeted the aid workers on purpose because we thought there was a Ukrainian terrorist on board. And so we murdered them all. Oh, by the way, we target ambulances. We've destroyed every hospital in Ukraine area that we control. We've murdered 99 journalists more than any other conflict since we started tracking it in 1992. We've done all of these things, but the Trump administration says they haven't committed a single war crime. Well, everyone in media would laugh them out of the building. And they would say the big lie and outrageous and Donald Trump is owned by the Russians. And that the Russians completely control him because of money, et cetera, et cetera. You know with absolute certainty, even if you're the most hardcore Democrat, that they would say that.
Absolutely.
But you switch it to Biden and Israel and all of a sudden, barely a peep.
100%. Now, I do want to give some of the journalists at that presser with Kirby some credit because they did ask some good questions, including whether the Biden administration would ever reconsider providing weaponry to Israel as they continue carrying out the slaughter of innocent civilians, reporters, and yes, even humanitarian aid workers. Let's watch.
How can the U.S. continue to send military aid to Israel without any conditions? Is there no red line that comes to
you? You know, we've had this discussion, you and me, quite a bit from up here. They're still under a viable threat of Hamas. We're still going to make sure that they can defend themselves and that 7th of October doesn't happen again. That doesn't mean that it's a free pass, that we look the other way when something like this happens, or that we aren't and haven't since the beginning of the conflict urged the Israelis to be more precise, to be more careful, and quite frankly, to increase the amount of humanitarian assistance that gets in. I haven't been asked about it yet, but I expected I would be. You know, there was a discussion just yesterday with our Israeli counterparts about Rafah. Now, this one was done virtually. We expect there'll be an in-person meeting here in a week's time or so. But the whole reason to have that meeting was to talk about our concerns over a major ground operation in Rafah and to present viable alternatives for them to be more precise and more targeted.
You know, Cenk, the other thing that really stands out to me about this current leadership we're experiencing here in the United States is how much the Biden administration seems to love posting their L's, right? In this case, you know, we wagged our finger at Netanyahu and said, don't be a bad boy and don't do this and that, don't invade Rafah. And then Netanyahu, without fail, goes on television and says, we're gonna invade Rafah, F off.
And you know,
that's embarrassing to the American people, okay? This is not strong leadership, it's embarrassing.
And do you know what Kirby and Biden did after Netanyahu slapped them across the face? They said, here's a free $2.5 billion gift courtesy of the American taxpayer. Please murder more Palestinians.
Yep, exactly.
And then they said, and by the way, we'll then sell you an extra $18 billion, including 50 F-35s, 2,000 pound bombs, so you can murder more Palestinians. And by the way, why are they doing this? So you can get your feelings hurt and you could call me any name in the book you like. AIPAC. AIPAC says they're gonna spend $100 million in the next election, and whoever kisses their ass more, and in their case, yes, they're theoretically getting money from American citizens. I would love to have that investigated. No one will ever investigate AIPAC in terms of, are they really getting it from American citizens, or is it foreign citizens that are also funneling in money? I don't know, I legitimately don't know, okay? But let's assume they're American citizens. But they say we are American citizens that care about Israel. And we want America to serve Israel. You are to do whatever Israel says. I don't care if it's a left-wing government or right-wing government. Shut up and do as you're told. And Joe Biden and John Kirby and almost every other politician in Washington says, yes, sir, thank you, sir, absolutely, sir. And they bow their head. If you're going to claim that AIPAC and the $100 million that they're spending is not relevant to the politicians, please say it out loud. I'll debate any prominent figure on the left, right, or in the middle who wants to make the lunatic argument. I would love to have you on camera, on air, make the mentally deranged argument that politicians don't care about the millions of dollars that they're getting from AIPAC or AIPAC might spend against them. Go ahead, I dare you. Say it with a straight face to the American people. Lose all credibility. It isn't about just, it's definitely not about AIPAC being Jewish. It's about AIPAC being lobbyists. The same goes true for Raytheon, ExxonMobil, and Pfizer, okay?
Yeah, it's important to really differentiate the notion of a Jewish lobby, which AIPAC is not, with a pro-Israel lobby. AIPAC is a pro-Israel lobby. In fact, many of the funders to AIPAC are evangelical Christians. So this is not about Jewish people at all, okay?
Yeah, and it's in the name. They have Israel in the name. Another group that's associated with them, Democratic Majority for Israel. They say, we are giving you money or we're gonna spend tons of money against your opponent as long as you do as you're goddamn told and serve Israel. It's true of any country. They could get American citizens that are aligned, and they do. They just don't have quite the same amount of power as accumulated over the years as a lot of other lobbies have accumulated power. But yes, Joe Biden doesn't mind Israel. In fact, aids, abets, finances the murder of tens of thousands of Palestinians because he gets paid to. So that's a fact. Your pretty little heart can break over it. You can call me dirty names. It doesn't change the fact that not only is that an obvious fact, everyone in America agrees with me. So maybe everybody in Washington agrees with you and you could feel great about that. And yes, you have power and we don't, right? But it doesn't make what you're doing right. It makes you morally reprehensible. I don't want the John Kirby's and the Joe Biden's of the world to ever darken my doorstep. They are evil, deeply immoral characters. And history will write that they gleefully funded a genocide and then covered up the crime. Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun, but you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.